Hello students, myself Arthik KS. I am going to present the video on the chapter Introduction to Computer Organization and Operating System of Session 5, Memory Hierarchy, Auxiliary Memory. We will see the table of contents. What is an auxiliary memory? Characteristics of the auxiliary memory. Characteristics of secondary memory. Hard disk drive, CD drive, DVD drive, pen drive, and the last one, Blu-ray disc. Next we see about what is an auxiliary memory. An auxiliary memory is a second classification of the memory in a computer system. It is also referred to as secondary storage. It is the non-volatile memory, which means the data is going to store permanently when a power is switched off also. It is lowest cost, highest capacity, and the slowest access storage. It is lesser cost. It is used to storage large amount of data and slowest access storage. We cannot be accessed very fastly in this type of auxiliary memory. It is not directly accessible by the CPU. Instead, it stores the non-critical system data like large data files or documents, programs, and other backup information in an auxiliary memory. First, the data or information of the auxiliary memory is transferred to main memory, and then that information can be accessed by the CPU. CPU cannot directly access the data from the auxiliary memory, but it can access it from main memory. Hence, whatever the data stored in an auxiliary memory is transfer to main memory, and then the information can be accessed by the CPU. Next, we move on to the characteristics of the auxiliary memory. First one, non-volatile. What is non-volatile memory? Data is not lost when the power is switched off also. Like in the main memory, the data is going to get erased when the power is switched off. But here, it does not happen that. Next property, reusable. The data stays in the secondary storage on a permanent basis until it is not overwritten or deleted by the user. The data stored in a secondary memory, it is permanent until it cannot be overwritten or until it is deleted, the data cannot be erased. Reliable. Data in secondary storage is safe because of high physical stability of secondary storage devices. Secondary storage devices have a strong resistance wherein until the physical damage of the hardware devices, the data will not be erased. Convenience. With the help of computer software, authorized people can locate and access the data quickly. It can access the data quickly by using some of the softwares. Capacity. Secondary storage can store large volumes of data in sets of multiple disks. Cost. It is much lesser expensive to store data on tape or disk than primary memory. It is much lesser expensive to store data in primary memory. We'll see the characteristics of secondary memory. First one, it is non-volatile. That is, it retains the data when power is switched off. When the power is switched off also, the data is going to retain. Second, it has large capacity to the tune of terabytes. Up to terabytes of data can be stored in the secondary memory. It is cheaper as compared to primary memory. As compared to primary memory, it is cheaper. Diagram we will see. What are the different types of devices which comes under secondary memory? First classification is fixed devices. Next classification is removable devices. Under fixed devices, we have hard disk drive, CD or DVD drive. Under removable devices, we have pen drive and Blu-ray disc. Next, we move on to the hard disk drive. So, what is hard disk drive? It is made up of series of circular disks called platters. So these are called circular disk, and each and every disk is an half inch apart combined with a spindle. This is called a spindle. Discs are made up of non-magnetic material like aluminium alloy. The disc is made up of aluminium alloy and it is coated with a magnetic material, and it is the width of this disc is 10 to 20 nanometer, and standard diameter of this disc is 14 inches, and they rotate with the speed varying from 4200 rotations per minute for personal computer and 15,000 rotations per minute for servers. So magnetic disk is going to rotate on the circular disk around 4200 rotations per minute for personal computer and 15,000 rpm for servers. So data is stored by magnetizing or demagnetizing the magnetic coating. It consisting of data can be stored by using a magnetic material, and data can be erased also. A magnetic reader arm is used to read data from and write data to disk. A typical modern STD has a capacity in terabytes. Next we move on to compact disk. Compact disk stands for, it is also called as compact disk, or in a short form it is called CD. They are circular disks that uses optical rays for storing a data and performing operations such as read and write operations on the data. They are very cheap, as you can get 700 MB of storage space for less than $1. You can store up to 700 MB. There are three types of CDs. First one, CD-ROM, compact disk, read-only memory. The data on these CDs are recorded by the manufacturer. Proprietary software, audio or video, are released on CD-ROM. The data on these CDs are recorded by the manufacturer, and the data present in CD-ROM, it can be used only for a reading purpose. Next we have CD-R, compact disc recordable. Data can be written by the user once on the CD-ROM, it cannot be deleted or modified. Once the data written on the CD-R recordable, it cannot be deleted or modified or erased. Next we have CD-RW, compact disk rewritable. Data can be written and deleted on this optical disk again and again. So once the data has been written, it can be written or deleted again and again on this CD-RW rewritable disk. Next we move on to DVD drives. DVD stands for Digital Video Display. DVDs are optical devices that can store 15 times the data held by CD. So DVD is having a high largest capacity compared to CDs. So it can store 15 times larger than compact disc. They are usually used to store rich multimedia files that need high storage capacity. So it can store all multimedia information such as audio, video, recording or animation, etc. DVDs also come in three varieties: read-only DVDs, recordable DVDs and rewritable DVD. Read-only is used for only reading purpose. Recordable is used for writing. Once the data is recorded or written, it cannot be erased or it cannot be deleted. And rewritable, once the data has been written, it can be written any number of times, that is rewritable DVDs. Next we move on to pen drive. Pen drive is a portable memory device that uses solid state memory rather than magnetic fields or laser to record the data. It is a portable device, which means we can move the device from one place to another place, and also it can hold it in hand. It uses solid state memory than magnetic fields or laser to record the data. It uses a technology similar to RAM, except that it is non-volatile. That means once the data written on pen drive, the data cannot be erased. It is also called USB drive or key drive or flash memory. Next we move on to Blu-ray disc. What is Blu-ray disc? It is an optical storage media used to store high definition video and other multimedia files. It uses optical medium for storing high definition video and also other multimedia files. BD uses shorter wavelength laser as compared to CD or DVD. This enables writing arms to focus more tightly on the disk and hence pack in more data. BDs can store up to 128 gigabits of data. Next, we move on to the multiple choice questions. First one, DASH is also called auxiliary storage. A. Secondary storage. B. Tertiary storage. C. Primary storage. D. Cache memory. Answer is A. Secondary memory. Next, devices that provide backup storage are called A. Cache memory. B. Virtual memory. C. Auxiliary memory. D. Main memory. Answer is C. Auxiliary memory. Third question. Magnetic type is a type of DASH access device. A. Sequential. B. Direct access. C. Step. D. Indirect. Answer is A. Sequential. Fourth question. Which of the following is not auxiliary memory? A. Optical disk. B. Magnetic bubble memory. C. Magnetic drum. D. All are auxiliary memories. Answer is D. All are auxiliary memories. Fifth question. The average time required to reach storage location in memory and obtain its content is called A. Operating time. B. Access time. C. Storage time. And D. Read time. Usually, the time required to access the data from the storage location is an access time. So, answer is B. Access time. Sixth question. A disk drive with a removable disk is called A. Hard disk. B. Optical disk. C. Floppy disk. D. None of the above. Answer is C. Floppy disk. These are called removable disk. Seventh question. Which memory has the largest capacity storage among all? A. Auxiliary memory. B. RAM. C. Associative memory. D. Cache memory. Answer is A. Auxiliary memory. Eighth question. CPU cannot directly access which memory? A. Cache memory. B. Auxiliary memory. C. Main memory. D. All can be directly accessed. Answer is B. Auxiliary memory. From this type of memory, data cannot be accessed directly by the CPU. Ninth question. The number of characters or second that can be transmitted to the memory from the tape is denoted by the term A. Data transfer rate. B. Transmission rate. C. Transmission rate. D. Data mode. A. Data transfer rate. 10th question. The dots on the magnetic tape represent A. Binary digits. B. Decimal digits. C. Hexadecimal digits. Answer is A. Binary digits. Key answers. For question number 1, answer is A. 2. It is C. 3. A. 4. D. 5. B. 6. C. 7. A. 8. B. 9. A. And 10. A. Thank you.